Hey, it's Rob Brown with Rob's Vlog, and I'm here to talk to you about boat shows, maybe help with some questions you should be asking while you're overlooking for a new boat this year, and maybe taking a look at the background of your dealer. Who you're going to buy from, I think, is as important as what you're going to buy. And hey, if you bought from a bad one before, you know what I'm talking about. Hey, we're going to be at the Augusta Boat Show this weekend. The place is going to be full of nice summer boats and whatnot. And one of the first questions I think anybody should ask is, of course, what type of boat are you going to buy? There's going to be a little bit of everything over there. And I am a full believer, and people have already seen themselves sitting in the boat that they're actually going to buy in their imagination. They've seen themselves on the water having fun with their family. And that's all fine and well. Have you gone out and tried that boat before? Do you know that that's exactly what it's going to be? Have you been on a friend's boat? Always good things to take into consideration. And if you get that chance early spring, go out on a boat. Try a couple. See if a dealer's able to take you out for a ride on a lake just to do a demo. We do it all the time, and we think it's really important just to make sure that you get the exact boat. How many people are you going to have on the boat at any given time? And if you're only going to have 10 or 12 at camp at one time, don't feel like you have to buy a boat that's going to accommodate that amount of people. Take a couple of trips. Make it kind of nice. Everybody has a little bit of room. So getting down to power, how are you going to use the boat? Do you want a water ski? Those are good things to think of. Are you going to be just tubing? Is that going to be 50-60% of the time that you're going to use it for, or is it going to be just a few times a year? So make sure that you don't, I guess, buy a boat for that 10% of the usage time. Buy something for your core. That way you'll end up using the boat a whole lot more. The last thing you want to do is make an investment in a boat and then just not use it. So getting to the dealer, always shop your local guy. Most of the boats out there are comparable to a degree. It just depends on how long you want to make this, how long you want to wait before you make this investment again. A lot of boats, you hate to use the term, they're made for the life of the loan. So if you're borrowing money for 5 to 7 years, you can kind of expect that a lot of the boats out there are made, you know, to last 5 to 7 years. Look at the stitching on the seats. Look at the undercarriage of that pontoon. How is the thing put together? Does it look like it's going to hold up to you for you? And don't make decisions, or don't let a salesperson allow you to make a decision against your own common sense. Are 3/8 bolts stronger than 5/16? Sure. If you double bolt something, is that going to be more secure than single bolt? Sure. Those are just common sense decisions. 50-ounce vinyl, is it better than 38-ounce vinyl? Double stitching better than single stitching? Of course they are. Those are decisions you're going to make, so you're not making a decision against your own common sense. When it comes to choosing a dealer, how long have they been in business? What's their reputation? Go to the review sites. I mean, everybody has a Facebook page. Everybody has a Google page. Look at how the general public has been, reviewing them. What do they look like in your eyes? Everybody's had a little blemish here and there, but as a whole, how is that dealer doing? He's got 40 reviews, and he's got a 2.5 status. Maybe not so good. 4.5, not a bad choice. How close is that dealer to you? What are their capabilities? Are they year-round employees, or is it a seasonal business? How easy are they to contact? Do they answer their emails quickly? Do they answer their phones quickly? What is their service processes? Are they mapped out? Some of the things that Clark Marine is involved in that's really disciplined us to becoming what I feel is a better dealer over the last 15 or 20 years is we've adhered to a couple of programs. One is what was the 5-star certification process. It still is. It's pretty rigorous when you look at all of the items that you have to work with in order to mold your business into being compliant as a 5-star certified dealer. Another, which we've been 10 or 11 times, is a top 100 dealer. You'll see these logos and these certifications at only a couple of dealerships in the state of Maine. What we've done is gone out and used their programs to improve our businesses. And the reason we've improved our business isn't just to make a bunch more money. It's to make sure that we do a good job for you. And that's what's most important. How much time do you want to spend on the water? Do you want a dealer you call? You have a problem with a broken boat and it's a week before they get somebody to you? You call Clark Marine, you buy a boat from us, you call us in the morning, you're going to have a technician, a trained technician at your dock that day. We really focus on our 25-mile radius of our store in Manchester. That's a pretty good circle. The Belgrades, Cobsey, Marinacook, Sabatas, China Lake, up through that area. We really work hard at servicing that area. And the promises we make through our service department, we can stand behind because we work heavily in that area. I figure we're within 30 or 40 lakes of 30 minutes of us. And if we can't do a good job and make a living for the 30 people that make up Clark Marine within that range, we probably should quit. If the bulk of the boats that your dealer is selling are outside their territory, that might be a red flag right there. I'd be looking at what is their scheduling process. Do you have boats just brought in and dropped off? You're gonna own this for a long time. You're not gonna make this purchase every year. How are they going to work with you on follow-up stuff? That's really important. We have a great process in place here where you call. We're not going to take your boat away from you, take the boat away off the lake for you for maybe a bad radio. Chances are we'll send somebody to you. You make an appointment with us. We're here for you that morning. You drop the boat off in the morning. We perform the services that day. You pick it up that afternoon. You don't mess around. You just screw your schedule up for one day, and that's it. That's really the backbone of our service department right now. 90% of what we do is done on a scheduled basis. The other 10%, who knows what? Something is broken, it does take troubleshooting, it may take a little bit longer. But we don't have stuff sitting around here for 10 days, 2 weeks, 4 weeks. And that's the norm in this business and other places, unfortunately. That's the value of the certifications that we're involved in, is they've made us into a company that recognizes those issues in the field, and we've really tried to address them. So, hey, this is Rob Brown with Rob's Vlog. I'm really passionate about this stuff. When it comes to service, I'm really a service guy. I love the boat shows because I'm very social. I like to meet and greet everyone. I hope to see you over at the Augusta Boat Show this weekend. If you have any questions for me, please don't hesitate to email, stop by our booth, stop by our store. Be happy to help you any way I can and help you sort out how to go about buying just the right boat for you and picking the right dealer. It's Rob Brown with Rob's Vlog. Happy boating. See you next week.